Chinese smartphone manufacturers have been impressing us with their industrial designs since early last year. Be it Vivo's Nex, Xiaomi's Mi Mix 3, or Oppo's last year sensation, the Find X, they are pushing the envelope towards achieving the zero bezel look. Where Samsung and Huawei were busy putting notches and holes in their displays to accommodate the front camera, Oppo decided to take a different approach for their new flagship line, the Oppo Reno. They have put together a motorized assembly that holds the front-facing camera and avoids any kind of notch or a hole in the display. And this looks pretty cool in this shark fin style. We will get to this bit later in the video. Let us first talk about the overall hardware. And when you consider the specs, this device sits somewhat in the upper mid-range category. It has a Snapdragon 710 running the show underneath with a 6 or 8GB of RAM coupled with a 128GB or 256GB of storage space. But it doesn't have any expandable memory. And guess what? It brings along a 3.5mm jack. That's a good one for 2019, right? But when you talk of speakers, it has a single bottom-firing speaker for audio. Kind of a bummer because I kept covering it while consuming content. To keep the lights on, it has a smidge over 3700 mAh battery, which gets charged up to 75% within just 30 minutes through Oppo's proprietary VOOC charging. This uses a USB Type-C charging port. I did not experience a stellar battery life during my use and had to charge the device every evening. Overall, the device performed pretty well and handled the day-to-day tasks without any major hiccups. When you hold this device in your hand, there is absolutely nothing that says that this device is anything less than a flagship. Tapered glass at the back, meshing into the metal frame, and up front an edge-to-edge display brings up a pretty pleasant feeling device in your hand. I specifically have this ocean green color variant. It has this matte or frosted finish to it. It not just looks cool, it also avoids all fingerprint issues too and does not catch any smudges at all. Up front, the display is 1080p AMOLED variety, and count me satisfied when you talk about the color saturation or content consumption of any kind. In fact, watching anything on this display was quite a pleasant experience, since this was truly an edge-to-edge display without any cutouts or notches. The display houses an in-screen fingerprint scanner of optical variety, and this functions as expected. Neither it was very fast and nor was it very slow, but it brings along a good amount of accuracy on your unlocking attempts. At the software front, I was rather pleased with Oppo's take. It is no more a cluster of disconnected features and UI, and has rather matured towards a feature-filled and smooth user experience. It runs on top of Android 9 Pie. Oppo called their Android skin layer Color OS. And to be honest, it stands true to its name. Overall user interface and icons are very colorful and continue with this theme into the deeper menus and options like in settings, etc. ColorOS is more like an inspiration collected from so many other smartphone manufacturers. For example, the notification panel is specifically called the notification center and has a swipe down search reminiscent to an iPhone. Private folder concept is borrowed from Samsung's Galaxy line of devices, which allows you to create a parallel storage space on your device. And then you have lock screen gestures like OnePlus devices, where you draw certain alphabets on the lock screen to launch certain apps directly. Overall, it's a very feature-rich user experience and at this point feels good to use. Although, given Oppo's past track record, I am not sure how well the software updates be handled. They have been very lethargic about software updates on their previous flagship lines. Moving on to the camera now. At its back, it has a dual camera, a 48 megapixel main sensor coupled with a 5 megapixel depth sensor for those portraits and bokeh shots. Both of these cameras sit flush inside the back glass without causing any camera bump. And innovatively, they are protected from scratches through this a small marble kind of a thing raised slightly above the phone's back surface to not let the camera lens rub against the desk or your table maybe. Camera does not have any optical image stabilization and has missed on the wide angle and 10x telephoto lens that is present on its big brother, the Reno 10x zoom version. If you saw my recent videos on S10 Plus and Huawei P30 Pro, you would know how these things add to the versatility of a smartphone. Overall, the picture quality is decent and is as you would expect from the device in this category. Colors look nicely saturated and processing is good too. Although it has a dedicated night mode, but it didn't help much, except just taking a few seconds longer to click a picture in the dark area. It did not really help, it did not catch any extra light and what we are used to these days through Pixel's night sight or Huawei P30 Pro's night mode. It was just dark as I could see it. Nothing special about the night mode on Oppo Reno's standard version. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see how Oppo Reno's 10X line does it differently than Oppo Reno's standard line, because I'll be getting that in soon. The video recording can be done in 4K at 30 frames per second, and it has electronic image stabilization for eliminating the shaky footage. Now, up front is the innovative shark fin reveal that houses its 16 megapixel front camera. It takes decent selfies, and not just that, it also has a small earpiece speaker for calls. You can also use this camera to configure a face unlock, which you can use to unlock the device or unlock certain apps on your device. So every time you launch an app that is locked with your face, the shark fin comes out immediately and unlocks it for you. I quite enjoyed this feature, but I'm not sure how secure the face unlock is on this device. Not so much, I guess, since it is of 2D variety and not 3D like we see on some other flagships. Also, due to this mechanism, there is no IP68 rating, and hence you should be very careful with this device around water. After all, it is a moving part that kept collecting dust, and I'm not sure how long would it last. But again, Oppo has done it in the past, and there have not been many complaints of any mechanical failures on previous flagships. So overall, Oppo Reno looks like a decent device, has good battery life, has good software, brilliant build quality, and nice cameras. So what's the catch here? Well, there is one, and it's the price. The device retails around 500 euros, and at that much price, you can get OnePlus 6T or upcoming OnePlus 7 that I'm going to do a video about very soon. So what do you think about Oppo Reno? Do you think it's a worthy device? Tell me in the comments below. Or would you rather be buying something else? Do let me know what's your choice. Thank you for watching, guys. Cheers.